We have decided to keep our monetary policy unchanged. Why? A couple reasons, I'm going to mention two. One, we've seen big fluctuation on the Swiss franc. The Swiss franc remains highly valued in a fragile environment. The other thing that we're seeing is inflation. Inflation in Switzerland remains low. We've revised our conditional forecast downward. That matters.
At CNN Money Switzerland, we've been playing a game in the past weeks. It's called the SNB Challenge. And we ask chief economists, our guests, investors coming in the show, when the SNB, when they expect the SNB to raise its rates. And the consensus goes for September 2019. What do you think?
I can only confirm that that is also what I can read from the markets. As a member of the governing board, we do not give any forecast.
You mentioned in the press conference Singapore. It's been 5 years that the SNB has been operating there to manage the reserves and the exchange rate. You look happy. So does it mean that the SNB is there to stay, to grow?
As long as we need it, we will certainly stay there. We are happy in the sense, absolutely. It's been a great relief to have a team that helps us to be able to work when we get to sleep, to have a 24-hour and not to have it to be done from Switzerland.
Talking about the managing the reserves, some reports say the SNB holds more stocks of Facebook than Mark Zuckerberg. Can you confirm?
I can't confirm on any individual position. We do a large portfolio of stocks. That is absolutely true. It's the result of our monetary policy. In particular, it's the result of counterweighing on an excessively strong franc when we've had to intervene in the market. And now the importance is to manage these reserves adequately, and one of them is to have a large diversification.
So technically, this is possible?
We have very clear process to invest our stock portfolio. And one of them, as I mentioned, is diversification. We do it passively. We replicate indices. That allows us to make sure we have no under or overweight in any sector, in any company. And that allows us to really remain relatively market neutral.
Let's get back to Switzerland and talk about the financial stability report that you released this morning. Actually, I found the SNB sounds concerned that you expect more to be done to strengthen UBS, Credit Suisse, and also other large banks. You also have concerns about the housing market. How strong do you see then Switzerland compared to the US or to the euro area?
What I can definitely say is that we have a financial sector that is significantly stronger than it was in 2008. And that's a really important step forward. We have the too big to fail. It's a legislation that's important. It's legislation that is still being implemented. The banks, our systemically important banks, are doing their job. More is to be done on time, and it's important that these efforts continue.
But why more?
Because there's a regulation and the endpoints, and we're not yet at the endpoints, but there's a timeline for it, there's a time schedule, and the banks have been doing what they have to do according to the time schedule, but we're not yet completely fulfilled, the too big to fail, the way it's designed in the legislature.
So in your view, more to be done, yes, but the Swiss financial center still deserves the reputation of a safe haven it has globally?
In terms of the franc, absolutely, it is a safe haven. No, but I think yes, there is more to be done. But we need to get the right credit where it is due. That a lot has been achieved. It's just important not to stop now and to continue the process until its end.
In your monetary assessment, you also mentioned some geopolitical tensions around the world. How much immune is Switzerland to the trade war that we see getting more and more likely every day?
The difficulty with trade is that the direct impact may not always be that large. It depends how you define direct, whether it's, you can also have direct in terms of the supply chain. But the impact, the biggest impact is likely to be through the financial market. So it's much more on the confidence that it gives investors about the world outlook. And there are clearly risks, and those risks we have highlighted in our press conference as well.
but so far no impact on GDP. As you mentioned, the GDP growth is quite strong here.
GDP in Switzerland is strong. We expect GDP to grow 2% this year with a continuing fall in unemployment. This is all very good news. Interestingly, as I mentioned it earlier, our inflation forecast has been revised slightly downwards, particularly longer term.
And in talking about inflation, you're kind of happy that oil price is going up. It helps the SNB with to manage the inflation here in Switzerland.
Which prices are going up?
The oil prices.
The oil prices, I'm sorry. Oil prices, well, it's interesting. It's something we monitor. That's why our short-term inflation forecast was revised upwards because of oil. There's a lot of discussion. The interesting thing is right now it's both a demand factor and a supply factor that is what it seems. We'll have to see also the OPEC negotiation to see what happens on this front.
Let's finish by Switzerland again. The SNB is concerned about the housing market, both of because of the price and debt level here. And the SNB asked for targeted measures. They are necessary, writes the SNB. What kind of measures do you see?
Well, let me do two clarification. Important clarification is we are concerned about a particular segment of real estate, and that's the residential investment property, say apartment building renting. This is a segment where we do see the highest risk of a possible price correction. Prices previously have risen tremendously, and we also see vacancy rates rising. And this is why we are not calling ourselves for measures. We're making sure we're calling out the risk, and we find it's very important that there's no further risk buildup in this segment, both on the banking side as well on the borrower side.
So what will it mean concretely for borrowers, for instance?
For borrowers, they have to be very careful that they can absorb the impact were the prices to fall. In technical language, it's often measures such as loan-to-income value and loan-to-income ratios have tended to rise. So it's more making sure that the people who take the risk can also bear those risks if the situation were to change.